There is a widespread belief that nuclear weapons produce a kind of strategic stability between two states, that as long as two states have nuclear weapons, each with a secure second strike capability, that means they have weapons in hardened silos, on airplanes ready to launch, or on submarines. So enough can survive a major attack to retaliate and destroy an enemy's cities, then stable mutual deterrence, often called mutually assured destruction, will exist. And each side will therefore refrain from going to war with the other. So that's the simple theory of nuclear stability. Yet if you look more closely at the reality of nuclear history, you will discover reasons to believe that nuclear stability is actually quite fragile. In highly complex systems like nuclear arsenals, no one can predict and therefore fix ahead of time all the little things that can go wrong. And over time, the likelihood of little things going wrong multiplies, and low probability events occur and interact to produce unexpected and unacceptable risk. So that even if one believes that nuclear weapons deployed in a secure second strike manner might produce caution on the part of great leaders, there are still at least three major categories of problems one should consider in order to better understand the reality of risk. First is the possibility of accidental nuclear war. Second is how to avoid a preventive war during a period of transition when one side is building nuclear weapons and the other side already has them. And the third is when leaders draw red lines, making threats that lead something to chance, and they get caught in a commitment trap. These three problems with nuclear stability are not theoretical. When we examine the historical record, we can find multiple examples that demonstrate how these three factors, accidental war, preventive war, and a commitment trap, actually played out. Here I'm going to recount several stories to make this point. We will first look at the 1962 Cuban Missile Crisis, as well as early considerations by the United States leaders who contemplated preventive nuclear war. We will then examine another less familiar crisis between two other nuclear-armed countries, India and Pakistan, a crisis that occurred after the end of the Cold War, to illustrate how the destabilizing forces at work in 1962 can still play out even today, creating uncertainty and decreasing nuclear stability.